Ever since the first discovery of gravitational waves back in September 14th, 2015, LIGO have been detecting more and more gravitational waves, ripples in the fabric of space-time. The first observation of gravitational waves was emitted from the inward spiral and merger of a pair of black holes of around 36 and 29 times the mass of the Sun, and was the first observation of a binary black hole merger. Recently, LIGO announced another detection of gravitational waves, and this one, however, for the first time, was a neutron star merger, unlike the previous detections that were black hole mergers. It was detected on August 17th and lasted for 100 seconds, which is way longer than ever before. It was 130 million light-years away and 130 million years ago, when two neutron stars were orbiting each other, and due to their loss of energy through the emission of gravitational waves, they spiraled inwards and merged. Telescopes all around the world detected this in all areas of the electromagnetic spectrum. And around 1.7 seconds after the main gravitational wave detection, NASA's Fermi Gamma Ray Telescope identified a burst of gamma rays. This is fantastic news, because for several decades, gamma ray bursts have been thought to come from neutron star mergers, but we lacked any evidence to be sure. Before any detections made by LIGO, it was always thought that the main source of gravitational waves would be neutron star mergers, and up until this detection it has only been black hole mergers, which is surprising, because the universe overall has more neutron stars than black holes. But that doesn't necessarily mean there are more black hole mergers than neutron star mergers. It could suggest that black hole mergers tend to produce more prominent gravitational waves, and only now have we had a neutron star merger close enough and strong enough to detect. As I'm writing this script, LIGO announced yesterday yet another detection. It was detected before the detection I was just talking about, as it was detected on June 8th. It was emitted from two fairly light black holes, 7 and 12 solar mass black holes, produced from a distance of about a billion light years from Earth. After the black holes coalesced, a black hole with 18 times the mass of the Sun was left behind, which meant that one solar mass equivalent of energy was emitted as gravitational waves during the collision. This new area of astronomy has been a very fascinating one and continues to be so. We have learned so much from detecting these minuscule waves. Every time LIGO improve their detectors, we hear about more and more detections, and I'm fairly sure in the near future that detecting gravitational waves every month will be a normality. Comment down below your thoughts on these detections. Make sure you subscribe for more content on astronomy and futurism. If you enjoyed this video, check out my most recent video or my playlist on black holes. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day.